Okay, I got the subwoofer installed. A quick note is if you want to install this, it's probably going to be easiest if you take off your back seat. I did not do that. I chose the hard way, but that's fine. So you have a mounting strap here and a spacer down here. I know it's hard to see. You just drill through down to the bottom. Let's try and take you underneath there. And there you go. You just want to make sure you miss that cross member bar. Otherwise, you'll have to drill through that as well. So make sure you miss that. I have mine basically right there, and you can see it right there on the other side. Let's see if I can point to it, like right there on the other side. Okay, and that's how you mount it in. And then what I did in the back there, drilled a little hole into that black plate, and I ran all my wires through there to keep them off of the floor here in case this ever gets wet. The speakers lifted up on the spacers, so it's not touching the floor, and I didn't want any of the wires touching the floor. So I drilled a little hole back here and then ran all the wires back through that hole. Okay. There's a power wire, and God, my video is so dark, and I can't figure out how to throw a light on. Anyways. Tap into your 12 volt converter for your power. There's another wire. I followed the same wires I used for my EcoCast soundbar up to the top there. And there's an auxiliary out. Now, you might think if you cut the yellow tabs off marking everything, you might think it's the black one. These yellow tabs tell you exactly what's what. It's not the black one. It's the gray one, is your auxiliary out. And that's gonna go to your auxiliary in on your subwoofer. Okay, pretty simple right there. So if you've hooked up your EcoCast soundbar, Eco X Gear soundbar, whatever you call it. Pretty much the same at that point. You got power, and then there's that additional auxiliary. So, okay, let's see now. So they also give you, let's see if I can get a picture of this. Oh, there it is. And you can control your bass level from right here. I mounted that right underneath my steering wheel. I used a, actually, I just used a piece of two-way tape. But it does give you little flanges on the side with screw holes you can screw into. I chose not to. Let's go around to the other side of the cart, see if we can get a little better view. Sorry, guys, my video making skills suck. So there is wire comes out of there, and then this pops off. It follows your steering cable all the way down. And I'm gonna try and get you guys some better light. Bear with me one second here. Okay. Okay. So I mounted that. Ran the wire down behind that sleeve, and that's just a sleeve. So it comes off really simple and goes right back on really simple. And then I ran it down through there. I removed this plate, it's three screws, one, two, and three. So I could see what I was doing. Ran it down underneath the cart and just kind of followed the body line, all the way down, back, and underneath. Let's see. Let me get a visual of that for you. Oh, jeez. It's really hard to deal with. So, let's see. Where is it at? I gotta find it. I hit it so good. So basically, right up there, you see that black wire. Let me see if we get some light on it. And follow that all the way back. And okay, let's see there. And all the way over. And those are my connections right there, popping out through that little hole. Let's see if I can get a better picture. And that would be the green wire. And then it just plugs in to the other part of the green wire that comes off of the subwoofer. Okay? And then that blue wire, I didn't use at all, so that's just kind of hanging there. I didn't need it for anything, so. So yeah, that's that part. And then you can see I'm all tied up nice there, tied into my 48 volt to 12 volt converter. And did the same process I used on my EcoX Gear soundbar. So tied it up real nice. The zip tie, nice thick zip tie. I got everything out, you know, ported outside of that hole that I drilled in and stuck all the wires through, tied those up. Nice. I don't know if you'll be able to see that up there, but probably not. But I got them all zip tied up there. So, all right, let me get out of this tight space. Oh, God. It's tough for an old guy, people. So, that was pretty much it. Toughest part was because I didn't take the seat off, was putting the bolts through, drilling and putting the bolts through, getting them lined up right where I needed them. You're just going to be, if you have a, you know, Icon, see these little bumps? It's just going to be just on the other side of that bump. Same on the other side. And you'll see that screw right there, that other one right there. And that's where that metal bar is that goes across that you want to try and miss. So you want to make sure you're on one side or the other of that bar, of those screws, and you should miss that bar. So those are the spacers I was talking about that raises the base machine up. And let's see if I can get a picture of the hole I drilled over here now that I got some light. And there's the hole I drilled and put all the wires through that. So, yeah, but the hardest part was those bolts. It has, you know, washers on the other side, locking washer, flat washer, and a nylon locking nut. So I suggest you have an extra set of hands unless you have Go-Go Gadget arms, which I pretty much had to activate mine because I did this by myself. So reaching around the step here, underneath the cart with one hand, and the other hand reaching up in that cubby to hold a wrench on the top of that bolt so I can tighten everything down was a little tricky. And that's why I didn't make a video while I was actually installing it, because it would have just been bleep, 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 son of a mother, bleep, bleep, bleep. And the whole video would have been bleeped out. Anything else? So that was really it. Power, and then your auxiliary cable to your soundbar, and your switch here to control the base, and run that down and connect everything underneath. And that's it. I mean, you're done. There really wasn't much to it. I was making it out a lot harder than what I thought it was going to be when I first started this. So this video is already 10 minutes long. Let's see what she sounds like. All right, let's see if I can get some music playing here. Guys, hopefully that helps you out. Don't let it don't let it confuse you. It's pretty straightforward. I follow the little instruction manual, and you just want to tie up everything real nice. Take your time, do a nice job, nice and neat, and think ahead, and you shouldn't have any problems. All right.